everybody, my name's Ted. And you know, lately I have been going around throwing fire into a particular person's face. Now, my man in white tells me every week it's not nice to throw fire at people. But you know, you should go make a friend. That's what you need. You need a friend. And I thought, that's fantastic. I'll make a friend. And you know what? I did. Meet Barry the Otter. I don't know if he's an otter, but he might be an otter. And I made him. And you know what he told me? He told me, Ted, burn it all down. Burn Jaggers. Burn him until he can't stand anymore. And you know what? I'm going to do it. I'm going to burn him. I'm going to burn him alive.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, next week, that's going to be on this show, NAWA Championship Wrestling. Ted will be taking on Axel Jaggers in what seems like has been building for several months. Axel Jaggers is finally going to get his hands around the neck of that lunatic, whoever the hell gave him a show's an idiot, Ted, right here next week on NAWA Championship Wrestling. Make sure you tune in and you don't miss that huge matchup.
I want to say first, before we get started, a shout out to all my friends in Dutchland because they love the Golden Gladiator, and I want to introduce two people to me. AJ Frost, Mr. King, Mr. Vega, King Enterprises. You guys got a lot on y'all's plate.
We do have a lot on our plate. Now, there's one thing I want to address. That is Guido Marinara, also known as Johnny Ryder. That's what he's calling himself right now. He recently threatened me. He recently threatened me with physical harm. All right, so we're just exposing him, and what happens when a person's caught in a lie, they start to get violent. But you want to threaten me? You want to threaten me? Now you're going to have to face this. We're coming for you. We're not going to just sit back and let you threaten us without repercussions.
All right, it's going to be big, boys. It's going to be big.
Hey, you. Are you a professional wrestling fan? Check out the High Spots Wrestling Network. Hours and hours of the best pro wrestling on the planet. Streaming on your phone, tablet, PC, and available on Roku. Thousands of videos, all the top indie promotions. So what are you waiting for, champ? Head over to www.highspotswrestlingnetwork.com and check it out today. Hashtag HSWN. It's the best $9.99 in the biz.
All right, folks, I'm standing here with evil, mean, and nasty Thunder Chris Anderson, who's going to face Tanya Benge, I do believe, tonight.
You know what? Tanya, I think that's what everybody's calling him now, is Tanya.
Tanya.
Which fits a little bit better than a lot of other things I know he's been called, and I've probably called him myself. But I'm going to tell you something. I don't know what the belt's a cruiserweight title, right?
No, it's a light heavyweight championship.
Light heavyweight title. Yeah. Well, I ain't been a light heavyweight since I was in sixth grade. But I can tell you this. If I can't beat you for the belt, I'll just beat you with it.
Well, I can tell you something, too. You will not call him anything his ex-wife didn't call him already.
Well, I've heard that before, too.
Here we go.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's coming up. Thunder Anderson's going to be taking on terrific Saturday Night Superstar Tony Benge. That's going to be coming up very soon. Well, let's talk it back. Let's take it back. Excuse me. The Golden Gladiator number two. He's standing by with a very important interview, he said. Let's see what Golden Gladiator number two has in store for all you great fans of NAWA Wrestling.
All right, folks, you've been waiting for months, and I brought the man in. I went to Trenton, New Jersey myself. Guido Marinara Sr., Johnny Ryder's dad, is here. Tell us about having to live behind that 7-Eleven while your son's a heavyweight champion and won't do nothing for you guys. It's hard to even speak it. Three kids you're trying to raise behind that 7-Eleven all by your lonesome. I'm just glad you're with us, sir. Hey, you know, no words can express. Come here. Don't worry about it. I'm going to get this man some money. Just, y'all know that it's GoFundMe/Guido's Little Bastards. Help this man raise those kids, okay?
Here we go with our opening contest this week, as we got Chris Thunder Anderson. As you know, he's taking on the Saturday Night Superstar, the WCCW Light Heavyweight Champion. Terrific Tony Benge, is Golden Gladiator number two, joins me here.
Oh, I'm back.
You've got some serious issues, man. Johnny Ryder's going to kick your butt. You and this Mike King guy don't stop it with this Guido Marinara stuff.
You're going to get your butt handed to you. I hadn't been believing it. And then when Mr. Marinara Sr. showed up, it just
breaks
my heart.
You're just as much at fault for this as Mike King and King Enterprises is.
You know, it tugs on my heartstrings.
You have got some serious mental to think that, man. Johnny Ryder's not somebody I would want to be messing around with. Why are you doing that?
That
neck brace is going to be permanently on you if you keep going on.
Sometimes you have to stick your neck out for these kids, and that's exactly what I'm doing.
Well, here comes Saturday Night Superstar Tony Benge. He don't got the robe on. He don't got the belt. Where's the belt, Tony? Don't call me Tanya Benge.
I bet he's got it in safekeeping.
Well, I guess he realized Chris Thunder Anderson wasn't a light heavyweight, so there was no need to bring the belt to the ring.
Truth be known, I don't think any of the three people in the ring could ever be considered a light heavyweight.
What do you mean three people?
Greg Robbins. Greg Robbins.
Well, Greg.
Yo.
Greg is a great official here of NAWA. He's going to be in charge of this matchup here between Tony Benge and Chris Thunder Anderson. The fans are hollering that Tony's got something, as he's being thoroughly checked.
He's got some skills
by the official here.
He does got something. He got moves.
I don't know how many moves Tony Benge has left.
He don't mean,
look,
but
the
has
fans
like
pointing at something. What has he got? He's curling. He's got something behind his back here. Tony Benge, what is he doing? I don't know what's going on.
The referee checked him. He can't find nothing. That's what's going on.
Well,
he obviously don't have anything.
I'm not sure what's exactly happening here, but
you know what I think happened?
I don't know what happened.
I think a few of those people drove up from Packlet.
You need to leave the people of Packlet alone.
I'm trying to, but they keep following me around.
We've got great action.
Be their mayor. I don't want to be the mayor of Packlet.
Look at that. Tony Benge's got that chain.
What?
And he's tucking it under his tights there.
That's great camera work, but Guy Tonight does not need to be zooming in on him tucking his chain up in his tights.
Chris Thunder Anderson is being told by the fans that Tony Benge has something, and he's going to tell the referee Greg Robbins.
Yeah, he's telling Greg Robbins that.
And now he's telling the fans to hush, as he almost got caught red-handed here.
I bet Thunder Anderson and Greg Robbins are in cahoots.
I don't know if Craig Robinson wants to thoroughly check Tony Benge where
he just
got that chain.
Man, if Greg can't find it after two or three checks, he don't have it. Let it go, Greg. Thunder, I thought you was a man. Just fight him.
Well, Chris Thunder Anderson is definitely evil, mean, and nasty, but even being that, you're no match for a chain, especially if you get hit with it.
Yeah, and for some reason, he wants to wrestle the Moonshine Boys. That don't make no sense.
We're still trying to figure out who left Thunder Anderson laying in that locker room several months ago now.
I know who it was.
Well, who was it then?
Adam James.
It may very well have been, but he doesn't seem to think that, as they're still a team.
Adam really don't like Thunder.
Here in NAWA.
That's what he told me on the phone, but I didn't want to get nothing started.
You guys were all in a faction together at one point.
We were.
And you can hear the fans, they have a disdain and a hate for Tony Benge, as he's got, as they say, he has a foreign, and there he is, he does have a foreign object. He's got a chain, he's stuffing it under the apron. Didn't do a very good job of it.
What are you talking about? I looked away for a minute, I didn't see him.
As I think Tony Benge is going to try to do everything he can to win this matchup.
Look how George Southman finally took his jacket off. You know, if I'd have been Tony, I would have put my shirt on top of that chain and nobody would have ever seen it.
Well, the Saturday Night Superstar has got something planned for Thunder Anderson. And
you know, that's part of Tony's problem. He's a Saturday Night Superstar, so Saturdays at noon, he's not really on it.
Well, he's on it right now, and it's Saturday at noon. We're probably 10 minutes into the program already.
So that means it's 12:10.
That's right.
That's
if you're watching this live, ladies and gentlemen.
And why wouldn't you? I mean, you know, I live to see me live.
And you can catch us each and every Saturday at noon right here on Facebook or YouTube, whichever platform you're watching us on right now.
And share away, just like my boys across the pond.
And guess what? We are the longest running episodic TV show in the Carolinas, 188 weeks in a row, ladies and gentlemen. I think that's pretty darn impressive.
We close in on 200. We close in on a Christmas night special. Christmas Chaos number 2. We're closing in on a New Year's Day special. This is exciting.
You think we're going to have all that? You've really got the scoop on me here.
Yeah, I was talking. Me and Zach
were talking.
You're
talking, huh?
Yeah.
Who is this Zach Thomas, and what does he have anything to do? Oh, look at that. Reversing right in that top wrist lock.
Well, as you see, he come out and managed me and Myrick Moore when we beat the Belt Collectors, and we're the new tag team champions of the BCW.
Well, that happened last week, but you got a little bit of the facts mixed up there.
No, we beat them. We're the champions.
Well, what's your belt? Why don't you have it with you?
We don't have our belt.
Tony's belt for this matchup.
I don't have the belt because Digger Brown jumped up out of his wheelchair like he does, grabbed him, took off running like Usain Bolt because it's all an insurance scam. I mean, you know, it's terrible what I have to live through. But I've still got a lawsuit going on. You saw the neck brace.
Well,
I might
Anderson
just add
there.
Those idiots to the lawsuit.
Well, Thunder Anderson throwing Tony Benge down to the mat out of that top wrist lock. And we're about to lock it up here again. And here
so
we go.
Two wily veterans locking horns.
Well, Tony Benge sneaking right out of there.
You know, Tony Benge has nearly 30 years of experience here in the squared circle.
Nearly?
Nearly. 29.
How many does Thunder Anderson have?
57. He's old. Him and Dion started about the same year.
Well, here we go. No matter how long they've been at it, Thunder Anderson is looking to catch Tony Benge.
It's Tony Benge.
Here we go, locking back up. Whoa, scoops him up.
Oh.
Drops him down with that big body slam.
Hey, in all seriousness, do you think Thunder Anderson wears adult diapers?
Somebody get this guy out of here.
You know what I think? I think it just depends.
And now he's got dad jokes. Well, here we go.
Good Lord. But, you know, the way his trunks and tights are, you could never tell. Even in person, you can't tell he wears an adult diaper.
Well, Tanya Benge is going around to where that chain was stashed at, and he's got it in his hands. He's got it in his possession. And Thunder Anderson is very unaware of what's going on. He's got it wrapped around his fist.
Ask for timeout, Tony. Just say if you can get 30 seconds. 30-second timeout.
Tony putting the chain back. Didn't put it to use just yet. But I'm sure he's got plans to use it if the match is not going to go his way.
Well, I would, too. I'd punch that old idiot with a chain.
And we've seen Tony Benge.
And I'm not talking about Greg Robbins.
And we've seen Tony Benge over the last several months do whatever it takes to get the win. He's picked that chain back up again one more time as he wraps it around his wrist again.
You know, it's a wonder that our cameraman didn't steal it because I heard he got sticky fingers.
Well, here we go. Oh! A shot right into the midsection with that chain.
What chain?
And the referee doesn't know what's going on. The fans are trying to alert our official that Tony Benge is cheating here.
You know what? Only way they'll be able to talk to this man, he speaks stupid. He don't even speak English.
Well, he's just choking him with the chain now. And Tony Benge is smart. He's taking advantage of the rules.
Break them eyes. If you can't see you, he can't hit you. Yeah, you do. Get him. Stay on him. Don't talk to these idiots.
If he keeps talking, he might get blowed up here, but he's choking Thunder Anderson right over that middle rope.
All three of these men are sucking air.
Tony Benge, well, that means they're alive, they're living, and in color. And here we go, Thunder, oh, pig right hand.
And live in color? Isn't that a band?
Taking Tony Benge right off of his feet.
Now Michael's dating himself.
Shoots
ducks the clothesline. Oh, straight to taking the wheel out.
Well, it's actually an old television show that I used to watch, so I'm not outdating myself as much as you think. Well, here we go, working that knee over now. He may not have any use for that chain later on in this matchup. Now that he's taking the leg of Chris Thunder Anderson out.
Go out there and punch his kneecap. There you go.
And Tony Benge just starting to take advantage.
Spinning toe hold. As you say, he's channeling his inner Dory.
I don't think that's a spinning toe hold.
That's what I called it.
I know, but that's not what it is.
What would you call it?
Oh, here he's got the top rope, getting some more leverage on this knee of Thunder Anderson here.
Fans, if you need to, we'll start a Twitter poll, and you can tell me if that's the right move or not.
Well, here we go. That's the right move, is to continue to work on the left knee of Chris Thunder Anderson here.
Stay on him, Tony. If you want to beat him, you got to stay on him.
Oh, there's a shot right into the midsection.
Oh, quick jab. You think Tony could have been the one that laid Thunder out with the pop?
He might. We still don't know. That's still a big question mark here in NAW. Oh!
Jeff Hart asked if it was a crack pipe. He said if it was, it was probably Little Donnie that did it.
Well, he did call him a junkie and a no-good American.
Oh!
With a spine buster.
Modified spine buster.
He wasn't able to get him all the way up because of that knee, that damage to the knee from Tony Benge. Thunder, see the pain on his face there.
Big kick out there by Tony. He's still got a lot of
– where's Tony going?
He's probably going to get there to get a little breather. Call a 30-second timeout, hit the floor.
Wait a minute, he's leaving. Tony Benge is leaving the arena. No, wait a minute. He's got a steel chair. What's he going to do with this steel chair?
I bet the guy at the Legion Hall is having a aneurysm right now, seeing this idiot walk in there with a steel chair. He's probably going to be in the ring himself. Keep Terry out of the ring.
Well, the official Craig Robinson sees the chair.
It's Greg, it's not Craig.
What?
Greg Robbins, not Craig.
Greg.
Why do you call him Craig?
I don't know what his name is.
You ain't going to call Thunder something wrong.
You're going to call him Craig.
I'm not calling him. Redbeard ain't here.
Well, there's a steel chair in the ring, and our official, I'll call him
Greg Robbins.
Greg Robbins has gotten the steel chair out of the ring. But now Thunder Anderson.
What are they doing? None of this
makes
sense.
He's grabbing it. What in the world is going on with this chair?
That chair costs $20, boys.
Tony Benge. Wait a minute. Smacking the mat. Tony Benge caught red-handed with the chair after Thunder Anderson tricked him. He's laid out cold.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
And that's the end of this matchup. As our official.
And you hear
Greg
Robbins, youngest ring announcer, Austin Freeman in the background.
Greg Robbins
saying that Thunder Anderson won via DQ.
And
what?
He's got a chain and a chair.
Punch Greg.
This match is over.
Hit somebody, Tony. You got railroaded. This feud is not over. These two men are going to lock them up. I see a no DQ match coming up down the road.
Well, Tony Benge thinks he's the winner, but declared victorious was Chris Thunder Anderson, ladies and gentlemen. What a way to kick off this week's episode, as Tanya Pidge is upset about the outcome here.
That we did, Tony.
Well, that's how it goes. He got caught red-handed, and that's the way the cracker crumbles.
It's a cookie that crumbles.
Well, our cracker crumbles too, brother.
Hi, I'm Vicky, here with the legendary Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson. After all these years, they're still two hot dudes.
You know, Vicky, you're a lot prettier than your old man, Chad. Unfortunately, Ricky and I, we're not as hot as we used to be.
Oh, whatever, Robert. But you know, with American Air and the Rock and Roll Express, we'll always be too hot to handle.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're back right after that very fast, quick commercial break. Thank you for sticking with us on this episode of NAWA Championship Wrestling. We're heading back down to the ring. As you can see, King Enterprises making their way to the ring, as you got Zay Vega, who we saw a few weeks ago defeat Stacy Sykes on the show as Michael King's newest acquisition. Well, here goes Michael King. He likes to hear himself talk. He is a walking fortune cookie, ladies and gentlemen.
The Asian sensation, Michael King. I am from everywhere. I've seen everything. There's not a move I can't counter. There's not a strategy that I can't defeat. You got problems, I've got solutions. I am the ultimate solutions provider. And I introduce to you today the Singapore.
We're getting worldwide here with Zay Vega. The Puerto Rican brought the Asian brought the Puerto Rican. He said he was channeling his inner Vanilla Ice there.
I think
you got problems. Yo, I solve it. Check out the mic. I'm a DJ revolves it.
I think he said he was Singapore. Please don't sing lyrics. We can get kicked off the air for copyright issues. And, you know, we've been threatened a couple times over the years.
The Asian sensation got the Singapore assassin.
I don't think Zay Vega looks like he's from Singapore, but that's another topic for another day.
Well, AJ Frost don't look like he's from America.
King Enterprises has expanded here before eyes
worldwide.
Rapidly.
Oh, everybody's favorite nerd, Stuart Snodgrass.
And here he goes. He's making what could very well, ladies and gentlemen, be his farewell tour around that ring here in NAWA Championship Wrestling.
Yep. You know what gets his mom off?
What?
I'll tell you afterwards. It's crazy. I never thought about taking jumper cables into the bedroom like that, but that was different.
Well, Stuart Snodgrass has made it through the ropes, and he's successfully entered the ring.
That was the craziest 12 hours of my life.
Now, we've seen him grow over the years here on NAWA Championship Wrestling from wearing those whitey tighties. He got tired of getting those wedgies, you know. He had to have one medically removed.
That is terrible. You know, he's really evolved as a professional wrestler from where he started. He's a,
you know, he used to be like a, you know, he looks like a Bruce Jefferson, if you ask me.
I know Bruce Jefferson, and they do look a lot alike. But Bruce was
Chip
from
Champion.
New Jersey.
I'm not sure which one it was.
Not Chip Champion. Chip was a Chippendale dancer, and George South actually ran him out of town. But Bruce looks a lot like Stuart, but I don't think they're the same person.
Well, I don't know, but Stuart Snodgrass is a 16-time Spelling Bee champion.
Now he's filling the referee up.
I heard he's won at least 8 science fairs in his time.
All in high school, probably.
Maybe so.
That's terrible. He spent 8 years in high school. You know, it's really not fair, like, when the younger kids are in there and there's a 27-year-old man competing against them.
This is your main event, ladies and gentlemen, this week. Stuart Snodgrass taking on Zay Vega. As he's taking control of that wrist and that arm of Zay Vega here early on.
He's got him.
I wonder if Stuart Snodgrass has studied and researched and studied this opponent.
Well, you know he
has. Not much to research and study. We've only seen him one time here on the show, so not much to make a game plan out of if you've been researching and studying.
Whoa, schoolboy. 1, 2. Look at that hair.
That's impressive. It's impressive he's able to kick out of 2 there.
Oh.
Big kick to the midsection there.
Oh, big arm ringers. Stuart's breaking down. He got that headband on. He's channeling in his 80s.
Well, Stuart got tired of, like I said, getting those wedgies, so he's modified his ring gear to a singlet and not a button-up shirt and whitey tie. Oh, trips him up.
The tripperoonie. 1, 2. You know who he looks like right now?
There we go. I don't know, but he looks like he's going to body slam Zay Vega. He's got him up, and he's walking around with him with ease, and down he goes.
Yeah, I didn't want to say nothing because I don't know if Stuart wants it known, but, you know, his dad was a pretty famous guy. He was the guy that did Sweating to the Oldies, Richard Simmons.
Well, here we go. He's going to sweat.
That's Stuart's dad.
He's
y'all.
Sweating in the
oldies. We give him.
Sweating to the corner, and yeah. Zay Vega.
Sends
it over with a big Russian leg sweep there.
He's pure American. He calls that the American leg sweep. 2. 1, 2. Referee Greg Robbins is not on it here.
You have to give it to Stuart for a nerd. You know, he's a pretty tough fella.
He is. You get beat up enough, you learn how to fight back.
Well, he's been beaten up over the years. And, you know, remember that study hall brawl, man? What a matchup that was.
It's hard to believe that's been a few years
Why
ago
do
now.
We keep reliving old memories of Stuart Snodgrass this week?
I
don't get it.
It just feels like this might be the last time we see Stuart. I heard his mom said they might be moving.
Well, I'd hate to see that happen because Stuart is everybody's favorite nerd.
She's got a job in Amsterdam.
The fans of NAWA Championship Wrestling love him. So be it.
I mean, did I ever tell you how I met Stuart's mom?
I
was at a truck stop once.
And then you picked up the Wanderer, Doug Riley, by mistake.
No, Doug Riley. I didn't
you
know
see Michael
there.
King there, the walking fortune cookie. Oh, grabbing a handful of hair and taking Stuart down.
The Gladiator Holics would probably love to hear story time with Uncle Gladiator.
Well, they're going to have to go on your Patreon and pay money for that. That's what
I should do that so I can tell you about how I hooked up with Stuart's mom in a truck stop in Strawberry Plains, Tennessee.
Well, here he goes. Zay Vega now in charge of this match. They're just stomping the hand.
Yep, she was the chief lot lizard.
Stomping on the hand of Stuart Snodgrass.
I need to get back to calling the action here. What are they talking about? Are they talking about conditioner?
He's got him in
the
corner.
He said, Greg, I use Perk Plus. What do you use? And Greg says, I don't wash my hair.
That thing's got to be loaded, that notepad, whatever that thing is. Somebody needs to open that thing up and check out what's in it. He just hit Stuart right over the hand with it.
Oh. Zay Vega staying on top of it.
Now he's going right back to that target he's put on that hand of Stuart Snodgrass. Thank God Stuart's got another hand for later on this evening.
This is very true. Very true. You know, I heard when he hears his mom in there.
That way he'll be able to write out his arithmetic problems.
Oh,
when he takes the test.
We're on the wrong
page.
What
are you thinking about?
I was thinking that Zay Vega.
I don't even want to know. Zay Vega is still in charge of this matchup, ladies and gentlemen.
Now he's stomping on the left hand. He just stomped on the right hand a minute ago. He's taking both hands out. Orange Stewart's ambidextrous.
Well, we're hopefully not going to have to find out that answer, but Zay Vega playing to the crowd a little too much here.
Remember the time that Stuart worked an Ironman match and won the television title that he never lost?
Yeah, he tore his groin, ladies and gentlemen. He had to give that TV title up, but you can go back in the archives here on our YouTube or Facebook pages and check those out.
That one time with his mom, I swear I tore my
episodes.
Groin.
And going up and over, Zay Vega.
Oh, duck. Hits the rope. Oh!
With a big leg lariat there, taking Stuart right off of his feet.
One, two. Greg, that was a three count, and you know it, Greg.
Only gets two to Zay
Vega. That's Michael King, he'll tell you.
The Asian sensation, Mike King, hoping that his charge, Zay Vega, can pick up the win here this week. I'd almost say it would be an upset if Zay Vega could defeat Stuart Snodgrass.
Stuart Snodgrass was the United States champion. He's been the television champion. He was an eyelash away from when we unified all those titles.
You were in that match, too. You lost in that match as well.
I won.
Oh, my God. Holy Christ.
Oh, that's got to hurt. And I won that match if George South hadn't came in there. And referee Mark Henderson was also involved in that shambles. I'm going to bring that up in the lawsuit.
And the hand, the poor hand of Stuart Snodgrass.
And the hand of God. That's what I got hit with from Amp.
Yeah.
Whatever happened to Amp Dominic?
Heard it was pretty stiff. Anyway.
He is a crowbar.
The hand of Stuart Snodgrass being worked over. You see it's heavily taped there. And ladies and gentlemen, last time we saw Stuart, he had those fingers dislocated in that match against Johnny Ryder. What's he doing now? Stuart rolling. Ladies and gentlemen,
he's having a spasm. Somebody help him.
He calls out the honor roll. Two. Well, he didn't make the honor roll because he didn't get the three count there.
Zay, what did you?
Oh, runs right into that side headlock there.
That looked rough on the old eardrums.
Well, the honor roll was not meant to be this year.
Side headlock taker, slow it back down.
Look at the red face. He's squeezing the noggin of Stuart Snodgrass as tight as he can.
Stuart's got the trunks as he rolled him over.
Only good enough for a two count there.
Come on, Greg, check the trunks. He's got the trunks, Greg. Stuart's shoulders are down. One, two, three. He just beat him.
That you are not the official in this matchup, and he's not in a pinning predicament just yet.
Look
at how red the face and head of Stuart is. And Zay Vega's just got this thing clamped on.
Oh, punch, punch.
Letting it go. I don't know how smart that was, but that leg drop hit its mark.
Oh!
As Greg Robinson makes the two count there.
Let's send them the memo for my hook the leg class. I can get Zay Vega in there. He can win a couple of these matches.
Well, he's undefeated here so far, 1-0 in NAWA Championship Wrestling. But here we go. He's got his hands full against Stuart Snodgrass. The boy's just stepping on the left hand now of Stuart as he picks him back up. Now he's trying to got him in an arm bar, trying to get him back down to the mat, working him back down by the shoulder.
Oh!
And he's cinched on that Singapore crossface. That's what we'll call it, just so Mike King doesn't get his feelings hurt here. And the Asian sensation is watching on as Zay Vega is trying to end this matchup here against Stuart Snodgrass.
I bet he's asking Stuart what his fortune's going to be. Now he's going to tell him.
Well, he's got it cinched in, and he's getting closer to the ropes. He's edging his way over. But Mike King is right there, ladies and gentlemen, and he is not afraid to get involved in these contests. This is just trash talking Stuart.
Oh, he got the ropes.
He got the ropes. He's got to the count of five.
You heard him.
Go.
He said Stuart quit. Mike said Stuart quit.
Mike King is up on the apron saying that he gave up, that Stuart Snodgrass quit. He is about to get involved here. He's got Stuart by the throat. Here we go. Oh, nobody at home.
He thought
he was going to hit his manager there. Big kick. The final exam. He just hit him with the final exam for the final time. One, two, three, and there's your winner, ladies and gentlemen.
Stuart Snodgrass. We love you, Stuart.
Everybody's favorite nerd picks up the win here in the main event, ladies and gentlemen. What a way to end the broadcast this week.
And what a way to end Stuart's run in NAWA. If that's it, that you go out on top, buddy.
What are you talking about? The end of a run here, the end of an era. Stuart will be back here in NAWA. I can guarantee it. I'm sure it'll happen. Well, ladies and gentlemen, just in case that is, it's a good way to go out. But, wait, he's singing himself out. Well, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey. Bye, Stewie.
That's all the time we got this week on the program. Thank you for joining us. We've had a blast here calling the action. We'll see you right here next week on the show. Take care. So long for now.